Today we are reviewing the Carson BAK4 10x42 binoculars. We're really excited about this one, if you can't tell, maybe a little bit too much, because we filled this table with a whole bunch of different binoculars in a much larger review that you should definitely check out after this video, because there we'll kind of highlight just the best binoculars that we found in our ridiculously extensive testing. But today we're focusing all on these Carsons, and they're a very solid choice.
Yeah, absolutely. I am thoroughly impressed by the build quality and by the optics. And the reason I'm so impressed is because of the quality of all of this, given the price point. When we tested...
The price point and the name.
And the name, yes.
It's not really a brand I'm familiar with.
Right.
For $150, I wasn't expecting too much.
Yeah.
And yet, it really performed.
Right. And so, like, from a... If these things break... Am I confident I'm going to be able to get the same level of service I get from Vortex or even from Styrka? Well, I've been hearing a lot about really high quality customer support, replacing your optics for you. Do I expect that from Carson? Maybe not, but I can go buy a second pair.
Right.
And I'm still back where I started.
They do say there's a no fault, no hassle warranty.
They do say that.
But I haven't tested that, so I don't know what to say there. So these are claimed as being waterproof, and given the external build quality, I would probably believe that.
Yeah.
What I really liked about this one is the form factor. There were some binoculars, the Nikon specifically,
that
just didn't fit me. Like it was just too skinny for my eyes, or the eye cups just felt weird, or you'd just move slightly off axis and you'd get black splotches showing up in the view, and they were just really tough to deal with. The Carsons just fit really nicely.
They use essentially the same form factor as the Leupolds and as like the Vortex and as the Styrka. It's just a better form factor, and it's impressive to me again that we get kind of the same or better optics out of this as we used to get out of the Nikon one, which is just a much bigger form factor.
Yeah,
yeah, exactly. So again, very impressive. A lot of thought, a lot of technology and design has gone into this. And again, this comes in at a similar quality to the point where when we pulled these out, I hadn't looked at pricing at all. I just looked at the binoculars, and we had these side by side with the Leupold, the Styrka, and the Vortex. And I took the four of those, and after just looking through all of them at various different things, I was like, you know what? All of these are just fantastic. They're just like very, very similar in terms of the quality that I was getting out of them. All of the like the difference between them were pretty minute.
Yeah.
And then when you put that side by side with what they're charging for them, I'm like, all right, yep, I'm pretty well sold. Yeah. I can't really tell the difference. I personally can't really tell the difference between this and a binocular that costs $100 more.
I think the you get what you pay for is not true in optics. I really just don't, except for the price tier, right? Like if you're spending under $100, you're just going to get something different than the $150 to $300 range.
Yeah.
And if we go to the crazy town and we're talking the $350 plus on a binocular, the difference between that higher tier and the mid tier is so minute that the vast majority of hunters could never tell the difference unless they could see the binocular. If you just gave them these eye cups from an expensive one and this one in a real hunting situation, they'd have no idea. And so I think this mid tier is the perfect place to buy for most hunters. You know, the marketing is on optics, spend as much as you can afford because you'll keep it forever. That's true, but you do want your money to buy something.
Yeah, and we have found that to be true, not just for binoculars, but just for optics in general. So rangefinders, we had the same experience. If you get to that mid-tier, which is really around like $300 for the mid-tier, $300 to $400 for the most part, with spotting scopes, you get to that mid-tier, you know, a $900 versus a $300 is way different, but a $3,000 versus the $900,
minimal. I totally agree with those two. The one that I think is the exception is rifle scopes.
Yes, I agree
with
that.
Rifle scopes, it's like, yeah.
The more you spend, the more you get.
There's a difference. But for the rangefinders and spotting scopes, I agree with you. That mid-tier is really a sweet spot.
Yeah.
All right, so check these out in the description. We have a link. We'd appreciate it if you click the link, even if you're not necessarily buying right now, because we spent a lot of money to put this review together for you, and it helps to support the channel. And give us a subscribe and check out our larger review of all the binoculars.